Hello students, hope you all are well and safe at your home. Well, I'm back with an interesting poem for all of you from your book Honeycomb that is titled as The Rebel, written by DJ and Wright. I will speak each and every stanza and explain you accordingly and then again summarize for you. So, first tell me, what do you mean by rebel? Okay, I will tell you about it. Rebel is one who revolts against accepted rules. We call him in Hindi vidrohi. एक ऐसा व्यक्ति जो अक्सर प्रत्येक स्थिति का विरोध करता हो और हमेशा अन्य लोगों से विपरीत काम करता हो. Read first stanza. When everybody has short hair, the rebel lets his hair grow long. When everybody has long hair, the rebel cuts his hair short. When everybody talks during the lesson, the rebel doesn't say a word. When nobody talks during the lesson, the rebel creates a disturbance. So what you understand that the rebel tends to keep his hair long when everyone else wears their hair short and vice versa. The rebel remains quiet amidst the noise all other make in class. However, when everyone else is quiet, the rebel makes sure he causes disturbance. Second stanza. When everybody wears a uniform, the rebel dresses in fantastic clothes. When everybody wears fantastic clothes, the rebel dresses soberly. In the company of dog lovers, the rebel expresses a preference for cats. In the company of cat lovers, the rebel puts in a good word for dogs. So, you can see that the rebel wears colorful and fancy clothes when everyone else wears a uniform. Conversely, he puts on simple clothes when everyone wears fancy clothes. When amongst dog lovers, he praises cats, and when with cat lovers, he has a good word for dogs. Now, read third stanza. When everybody is praising the sun, the rebel remarks on the need for rain. When everybody is greeting the rain, the rebel regrets the absence of sun. When everybody goes to meeting, the rebel stayed at home and reads a book. When everybody stayed at home and reads a book, the rebel goes to the meeting. Oh God! So, you can see that when all welcome and enjoy sunshine, the rebel talks of the need for rain. When everybody enjoys the rain, he longs for sunshine. When all attend a meeting, the rebel reads a book at home. And when all stay at home reading a book, the rebel goes to the meeting. Now the last stanza. When everybody says, yes, please, the rebel says, no, thank you. When everybody says, no, thank you, the rebel says, yes, please. It's very good that we have rebels. You may not find it very good to be one. It means that when all accept something gratefully, the rebel refuses it politely. And when everyone refuses something, the rebel accepts it with pleasure. It's fortunate that we have such rebels amongst us. Though being one may not be desirable since it makes you a misfit in society. So you can understand that rebel always opposes people. When short hair is in fashion, a rebel would prefer long hair and vice versa. When everybody is talking during the lesson in the class, the rebel will sit quiet. When there is pin drop silence in the class, the rebel would create a disturbance. When other boys go to school in uniform, he would put on colored clothes. When others in fancy clothes, the rebel will dress simply. If others are dog lovers, the rebel would prefer cats. And in the company of cat lovers, the rebel praises dog. When everybody is praising the sun, the rebel opines for need of rain. When everybody longs for rain, the rebel longs for sun. When others go for a meeting, the rebel stays at home and reads a book. When everybody agrees, the rebel disagrees. It is good to have a rebel in a society because those rebels help us to see life in different way. You might have seen rebels even in politics. They help the government to do work properly. But actually, rebel is mostly not liked by everyone. Rebel is not ungrateful or impolite when he refuses something which all others accept. He does exact opposite of what all others do, without meaning any disregard to the giver. But we can take something positive also from them. What are they? They have different views of things in life. Their ideas are not copied. They don't copy others. They have their own original ideas. Positive changes in society are mostly brought by rebels who go against the usually trodden path. They build a progressive society. So, rebels are also needed in any society. There are many traditions in our society that need to be challenged and changed if we are to progress as a civilization, such as a dowry system, a racial discrimination. But it doesn't mean that you need to be rebellion. We can keep our views before the society for good changes in a very proper and polite manner. Thank you. Have a good time. Goodbye.